Reach any port first video. Okay. Why you need this product? You have your Amazon account, you are here on your laptop, and the typical use case is that you need to connect to a database in the private instance or an EC2 in a private instance. Anyway, you want to use your private IP and reach a port inside your VPC, and in many cases you don't have any VPN system, transit gateway or whatsoever. You only need to reach a port. So what this product does for you, in a completely automatic way, it creates a tunnel, a temporary tunnel, as you can see here, and allows you to reach from your laptop a port like here a database. In my specific use case, you see here in the Milan region, I have this machine where there is a browser web, and I want to reach this private IP here. Okay? How it works? It's very, very simple. The first thing you need to do is download the program. You go in this repository. For example, I'm using a Mac, and so I download this so for this one Mac RM64. If you have still old MD, you can tell me. I add the binaries for that. So I click here and I click on download. Okay, in this binary there is everything. Oh, here we are. Everything you need to. One download is enough. Okay, everything you need to have it. It's a Python program, but inside there are libraries. There are the Python version, everything you need. After you downloaded, you need to if you see when you download a program, it's reach any port like that. You see here there is no execution permission, so I add like this execution permission with the chmod. Okay, and at this point I can do the first execution. It's possible that this program is recognized from an external source, and after the first execution, you have an error message, and you need to your settings, privacy, and allow the program. Okay. In my case, since I'm the creator of this program, it doesn't show me. You see, no, it show me perfect. So, because it's downloaded, so he doesn't know. Perfect. So, you see, you click OK. You click OK. You have this signal. I'm really happy this happened. Open the settings. You go in privacy. Privacy and security, and here scroll a little bit down, and you see here this is appear and so allow anyway. In this case, you need to use a password. I have, and that is done. If you are a Linux or a Mac or Windows, you don't have this. Okay, so now I can execute again. I can click open and. Here is loading. Here it should fail because I forgot to do. No, I have the permission that I need because very. Oh, I have loaded the permission in this terminal. It's very important that you need to before running the program, you need to have the AWS credential for the account where you want to run this. Okay. If you want more, if you are admin, of course it works. If you want set up the minimum permission, here in this article I explain everything about to set up a minimum permission. Okay, the first question it asks you is in which region you want to operate. So I select region number two, Milano. It's showing you only the regions that are enabled in your account. So probably you will have less. And in this is checking if the role necessary to work is already created, more detail on this role again on the article, and is checking all the VPC available in that region. So in my region, in my Milano region, I have three VPC, and the instance that I was showing you a moment ago, it's inside this VPC called test. Okay, so I select now zero test, and the application is running on port 80, and the private IP is this one. Okay, and you can put the private IP here. And for this test, it's okay to have the entire system running for only 5 minutes. So I put zero. The system will automatically destroy after 5 minutes. So you don't need to worry about cost. And at the moment, the maximum I put is 2 hours. After, to create a tunnel in Amazon Web Services, there are several ways, several possible ways, but at the moment I implement only the first one that requires a public subnet that has no bandwidth limit. But there are also others I will maybe implement in the next version. So I select one, okay, and it tells me that is going to register this information. Is my account ID and the country where I connect at the moment, that is Italy. And this is only nothing, this is all information are stored. Since the product is free, I want to know if people are really using it. So how many people are using it, how many times, it's just for my knowledge. So and anyway, you cannot do anything nasty with the account ID and the country. Okay, but just to let you know that I'm collecting this data, okay? So in this moment, the system is going to create, and a CloudFormation template is going to be created. And you can take a look if you go in CloudFormation, in CloudFormation here. You see, this is a new template that is going, new stack with a public template that is going to be created. You see, there will be like some resources, the same resources that we saw a moment ago in this diagram. There is the EC2, okay, here there is no role or security group, but is the minimum to work. From my experience, it's around 3 minutes, is around 3 minutes to create, okay? So you don't need to wait, you don't need to wait a lot, okay? What else? What else is useful to add? Already mentioned the system will auto-destroy. The system implements the minimum privilege system, the minimum privilege. Minimum privilege IAM permission. If you want to know more about minimum permission, go in this other article. And here I explain everything about how this one is implemented. Just that we are waiting in these 3 minutes, I want to remember one very important thing is that the this private IP, of course, it has a security group. In my case, the port 80 is open to the entire security group, but you can put like a more restricted rule like that is, for example, is open only from subnet or is only open from a security group ID, for example, this security group ID. Okay, maybe I will implement some automation in the next version of the product. Sure, is something useful. Okay, so yeah, you see that policy, profile, and and the last thing will be created is the will be the in-situ machine, and a tunnel will be created. While that you wait, why don't you go on the articles and click like on the article, and also go to the Reach Anyport page and follow the page to receive you see, following the page to receive updates about the new product. Okay. There is also the website where there is the download link, LinkedIn page, the YouTube playlist with this video that is going to be loaded, and so on and so forth. So let's see. Exactly, the 3 minutes are passed. You see that now the tunnel is open. So if I, and this random port was chosen. So if I copy this, and I open a new terminal, for example, I do curl localhost like that. You see, this is a private server. This is the private server that is in this EC2 virtual machine you see here. If I also refresh, you see this is the EC2 machine created by the CloudFormation template that through this you reach the internal machine. The security is very strict because the port SSH is open only from private IP. This is the private IP of my house. At the moment this will change, but so to explain that is implemented with also minimum restricted thing. Remember, so this is everything. Anyway, if you stop the program, don't worry, or if your laptop crash, don't worry, because the CloudFormation template delete itself thanks to this implementation here. So you sleep, this is the my instance EC2, is for the seconds that are passed, in this case is 5 minutes, and after there is this delete stack. So even if you close even if you close the terminal, the system anyway will auto-destroy, everything will be left clean. Of course, in this video, I didn't mention other details, but you can find everything in the two LinkedIn articles. Follow the page and give me your feedback. This is a new product. There are a lot of things to add, but first I want to know users what they think is the features to add, etc., etc. I hope you like it. Bye.